When I grow up, I want to be. Cuando yo crezca, quiero ser. Bueno, yo quiero ser muchas cosas. I always say that I want to be more. And you can always be something else. You can be so many things. So you just have to decide what you want to be. And that's why we have choices. We have choices here. Maybe you like theater, or maybe you like ballet, but you don't act and you don't dance. Well, let me tell you, there's a lot of stuff that you can do when you're part of that dance company or a theater company or one of this wonderful ballet companies. Oh, today we have a special guest who takes care, you know what? Of the costumes, the clothes that people use when they do ballet, like the Nutcracker, El Cascanueces. You think the dancers do that? They have somebody special who takes care of everything, even the little hats. So welcome, Bruce. Bruce Booth, we know him for a long time. And he is, tell me again, what is your position right now?
I'm the wardrobe director.
And you're gonna say, what is wardrobe? What do you mean?
Wardrobe. Wardrobe is anything that goes on the actor's body. So I'm in charge of all their clothes. And if they wear like wigs, I'm in charge of that. If they have special makeup, I'm in charge of that. If they wear special hats, I'm in charge of that. And of course, for my ballet company, they wear special shoes to dance in. And I do that also.
Well, you don't know, but he works for Ballet of Memphis. Am I correct?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And maybe you've already been there watching one of these wonderful ballets, like I said before, the Nutcrackers. Eh? And you say, oh, qué bonita ropa, they look so cute. Well, he's responsible of that. Mm-hmm. Tell me something. How did you decide to do that? Take care of the costume, to be behind the scenes, if you want to say it. How that happened?
Wow. Well, growing up, I've always loved to sew and to make clothes and to make dresses and things like that. And when I went to school, I found out that I can get a degree in it and you can learn how to design and like learn how to look at things a certain way and, you know, how to work with actors and how to budget and make sure you don't spend too much money. And you learn all the techniques about it. So I learned how to like do the technical side of designing costumes. And so I decided to get a degree in it. So I went to university, I got a degree in it, and then I've been designing ever since.
You see, my little ones, you have to go to school to do that. You can even get a degree. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
You see, wow, that's nice. And I'm sure you have to love to do it. To like you say, you like to sew. Do you have to be good drawing the costumes? Like a stick people, just, you know, like.
I think you have to be good at communicating. You don't have to like, you know, you can draw a pretty picture and that's good, but you have to communicate on what that costume is supposed to be. Because you have to, I mean, I just don't get to make it up on my own. I get to design something, but then I have to talk to the director and explain it to him to make sure that they like it. I have to talk to the actor or the dancer to make sure that I explain it well to them and they go, oh no, that can't work because I do this and that will get in the way or, you know, like that. And then I have to explain it to all the people who like help me sew the costumes together. So I don't know if you have to draw really well, but you have to draw in a way that communicates really well. And you have to learn how to talk and communicate well too.
Wow, this sounds like a teamwork.
Teamwork.
You, the dancers, the director, that sounds like you have to be able to work as a team. Am
like
I right?
Yeah, like a lot of jobs, you have to have other people to give you input because you know, I can make the biggest and prettiest dress, but if it doesn't work in dancing, or if it doesn't work on stage, or if they can't move around, then it doesn't work. So we have, there's a lot of communication that goes with it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, you see, my friends, you have to talk to other people. It's not just do your work and work. You have to communicate with every department and people. Mm-hmm. Okay, tell me something. This is the question that I always like to ask everyone. What's the best part of your job? What is the thing that you say, this is why I come every day here, because I love to do this? What would be that? What would be that thing that you really like?
I think overall, the best part of my job is that it's never the same. Every project is different, you know? Like, every show is different. Every character that I design for is different. Even if I design the same show many years later, it's different. So there's always a new way to look at it. Like, you know, I can design something 10 years ago, but now I'm older and I know more things, so I can add more things to that design. So it's always different, and that's the part I love about it.
Wow, nice. Let's go back to school, because that's something that sometimes kids don't understand it. Mm. They want to do things, but they say, maybe I don't need to go to school. How many years you have to do, or how many years is your career? And how many years it took you to get your degree?
I went to a university for 4 years. And in those 4 years, I took all the courses that gave me a bachelor's degree in technical theater. So I learned how to mostly design costumes, but I also had to learn how stage lighting works, because that affects the colors on stage and the colors of costumes. And I had to learn how to design sets that go with the costumes. And I had classes in I had history classes and theater history, political history, and then I had classes on how to work with directors, like, because directors have a different goal and designers have a different goal. So so we took a lot of different kinds of classes.
You see, kids, also history. And why? Because you're not gonna put a dress from the 1600s in a place that is the 1800s. Mm-hmm. Doesn't work. So there you go. There's a lot of things that you have to study and be aware. Thank you so much. Now tell me, what would be your advice? What do you tell the kids, the young kids that are watching right now and they're thinking maybe to follow your steps? What would be your advice for them if they want to follow in one day, maybe work for a company, a theater company, a dance company, doing behind the scene, doing costumes, or maybe, I didn't know that you have to learn about lighting, but now I understand, because if you make a dress, it doesn't look with that light, doesn't matter. Okay, tell us, what would be your advice for the people who wants to follow you?
I think my biggest advice is, if you're creative, have confidence in being creative, because not everybody will understand where you're coming from and not everybody might like what you do, but if you have confidence in it, you'll find the right people who will appreciate it, and then you'll get to do what you love every day. Mm-hmm. I think that would be the best advice.
That's nice. What will be the custom design that you always remember? You say, when I did this work for display, it was like the thing that I really, really like a lot. Your favorites? I know you love all of them.
I love all of them. I have a lot of good memories. Every show is different. I think that's why after 20 plus years, I'm still doing it, because every show, I still get an emotional feeling when the show opens, and then I go back and I see it and I see how the audience reacts to it. There's always special things I do in the show that I always look for. And yeah, so I still have that very special feeling towards it, But I don't know if I can narrow it down. There's just so many.
Well, you love what you're doing. That's important. I think that's something that the kids, you have to do what you love. Know yeah. what somebody else tell you, or your friends say, come with me and let's be engineers. And maybe that's yeah. not for you.
You should always just believe that what you do is important and that you'll love it. And then you'll never, then you'll always be happy when you go to work.
Okay. Well, I'm a little bit worried about what I'm going to say because you enjoy your work so much. My last question is, do you have a hobby? Do you have something else outside of your work that you like to do?
Well, I have a small hobby because most of my work is backstage, but I have a small hobby. Sometimes I like to go on stage and act also. So sometimes I do small plays with my friends here in town just to do it once or twice a year. So I guess that could be a hobby.
Okay, well, that is good. Bruce, thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for talking to the children and all our friends in Casa Teatro. Thank you. And we hope to see something nice and good in the future. I know a lot of things are kind of standby right now.
Yeah.
But
it just makes it more worthwhile when we come back and we get back into work again.
I can't wait to see what he's going to do. Woo-hoo. Okay. Thank you so much. And again, gracias, muchas gracias. Thank you. And I hope to see you soon. I miss you.
Thank you.
Niños, thank you. And see you next week. Remember, this is when I grew up. I want to be cuando yo crezca. Y cuando yo crezca, yo quiero ser. See you next week. Adiós. Hasta la próxima. Un beso de abuela Tomasa. Bye-bye.